Hi, my name is Pedro Pereyra and I'm a wedding and event photographer. I'm here today doing a quick review on the Canon 85mm lens version 2 1.2 aperture lens. I wanted to tell you guys I've owned this lens for a little bit under a year and I wanted to tell you guys my feedback on using this lens so that way if you're thinking about getting this lens, you'll know kind of what to expect from it. So without further ado, I'll give you the pros about this lens. Extremely sharp lens, number one. Extremely, it's a prime lens, which tend to be obviously the most sharper lenses. But again, this is known as the portrait lens by Canon. Definitely extremely sharp. I mean, you notice it on the photos, the sharpness in the eyes in particular is definitely noticeable. So sharpness overall, the piece of glass and everything, the way the images are compressed, unbelievable images. That's why they call it the portrait lens. So awesome there. It's also really well made. I like the fact that it's a heavy lens. It feels like an expensive lens. It's very heavy, fits the camera nice. I think it's got some metal, you know, it's made out of metal and maybe other materials, but I see metal. It definitely feels like metal. It's quite heavy with this 5D Mark III. I mean, I don't even know how many pounds this is, but it's, you know, once you hold this in your hand for a little while, you definitely start to feel the weight. But it adds to the richness feel. It's not a flim-flammy feel. Some years back, I believe I had the 1.8 version of the 85mm. Still a nice lens, still the portrait lens. I ended up not using it anymore because I didn't find it practical because of the fact that it doesn't have a zoom, which I'll talk about on the cons of this lens. So again, we talked about how sharp it is. We talked about the way it's constructed. Also, the 1.2 aperture is just a dream lens for you to blur out your backgrounds when you're out there doing your photo sessions. Again, at 1.2, just the blur effect, the compression, it's just really, really beautiful. As you can see on the slideshow of some of the images of some of the portraits and photos that we've done with this lens. Again, second to none, which makes it very good in low lighting as well. Because of that aperture of 1.2, you can really use it in low light situations and kind of use some ambient light if that's your style. But it's a beautiful, beautiful lens for that as well. But also, and it brings me to the cons about this lens, because we have to give you the good and we have to give you the bad. One of the cons about the lens is the fact that it is a bit slow to focus in lower lit situations. So again, when you're out there in venues, maybe some churches that are not that well lit, it might take a second or two in order to pick up the focus, because it tends to struggle a little bit if it's not well lit situation. Again, it definitely will eventually find its way. It just tends to be a little on the slower end, depending on how dark your situation is. Number two is the reason why I got rid of my original 85mm 1.8, which is it's not a zoom lens, so it makes it very unpractical. You know, you could only pretty much use this at, you know, for portraits, as it's called, the portrait lens. You can use it for some formal photos at the event, kind of a control situation based on the size of the room you're working in, your subject, how far away you're from it. But it's definitely not a lens that you can use pretty much for everything. Me being an event photographer, we're out there doing events almost on a weekly basis. I definitely needed something like a 24x70 2.8, 70 to 200 2.8 that can definitely cover all those focal lengths so that you're able to move around, bop around in a crowded event with sceneries constantly changing. There's just so many things going on that prime lenses tend to be a little on the unpractical side of it. And the last thing is the price tag. This lens comes in at just under $2,000, which I think puts it under the cons for it, because not everybody will be able to afford the lens. So do I recommend it? Yes, not as your first lens, but definitely as you go down the line in your collections of lenses, definitely it belongs someplace. My name is Pedro Pereyra. I hope you enjoyed this video and please subscribe to our channel.